dumbest.
Alright. Why'd you say you'd rather be the dumbest person in the world?
Nah, because if you're the dumbest, then you know all the wrong answers, right? So...
That's fact.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of GTV. I'm Cameron.
And I'm Harjith.
Today's GTV has the good stuff. I'm talking prom, 1X.
We'll take you out to Unified Trek, and we've even got the Josh fight.
All that and more after the pledge.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and moment of silence. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now a moment of silence. Thank you.
Finals are coming, GHS. You can get your final schedule from your email. Teachers are right here on the screen.
Good luck, and don't forget to at least try to study.
Prom is right around the corner, so you know what that means. Prom tickets are going on sale. Seniors, the deadline to purchase tickets is May 14th, and juniors, ticket sales open May 3rd through the 17th. Contact Mrs. Walters for any questions.
Graduation is less than a month away. Seniors and juniors who are graduating early, cap and gown pickup will be May 11th during SRT. Your SRT will have a scheduled time to pick up your cap and gown.
2 weeks ago, Goshen High School students and Technology Student Association, TSA, could be against other schools from across the state to qualify for the national competition. Several students placed in their respective events, with some even going to nationals. Here are all the teams who placed.
Here are the first place winners and those going on to nationals. On demand video, we got Brenton Pham, Jesus Rodriguez Ortiz, Cameron Schneider, and Joshua Schrock. In the technology bowl, we have Joshua Schrock, Harjith Rao, and Will Franks. Children's stories, we have Guadalupe Diaz Macias, Brenton Pham, and Jesus Rodriguez Ortiz. Structural design and engineering, Sophia Koschmeider and Natalie Esqueda.
Scoring in second place and also going to nationals is Josh Rock in CAD 3D engineering. And placing in third and going to nationals are Josh Rock and Harjith Rao for coding, though the team may be slightly changed for the event. Also, congratulations to Fernando Mendoza, who got fifth place in essays on technology.
Congratulations to all of our teams who placed, and good luck to those who are going to nationals. On another note, the whole Goshen TSA chapter came in second place overall for the state, beating out Penn. Way to go, student engineers.
Brenton, I got robbed!
Anyways, Goshen youth advisors are up for election starting May 20th. Election campaigns are active weeks prior to the election. By being a youth advisor, you can get in touch with our local government to see how it works. You will vote on decisions, but your vote doesn't count for the legal outcome. If you choose to become a youth advisor, you will participate in the governmental processes that help everyone in Goshen. The youth advisor attends council meetings the first and third Tuesday of the month at 6 p.m. There are more youth advisor positions available this year, such as the Common Council position, CRC position, Parks Board, and the Mayor's Environmental Advisory Board position.
The current youth advisors presented a proposal to have student representation on the Goshen School Board. Caden Dixon tells us what the board decided. Take it away, Caden.
The city of Goshen has had a student on the city council for a couple of years now. These students made a presentation on the board Monday night, and the board was so impressed that they went ahead and approved the measure. GHS students will now vote for their representative to be the voice of all GHCS students. Dr. Younghans also supports the addition of this advisor between the student body and the board.
One-act performances are coming up on May 8th and May 9th. Ryan has also made a video talking to some of the directors. Go ahead, Ryan.
I'm Kay Strong, and I'm a senior, and I have been a part of One Act since my freshman year. It helped me a lot get out of my shell and get out of my comfort zone and be a part of an experience that I've always wanted to be a part of, which is acting.
Hi, my name is Drexan Barón Rosales, and I'm one of the directors in One Act. It's really different than really anything else I've done in these past 4 years, and I feel like it's something that really anyone who enjoys just, you know, movies, TV shows, all just acting stuff.
I'm Katie Batson. I am a director and also an actor. As a director, I have experienced so much. I have learned to be a leader among my peers, which is a very difficult thing to do. And I've also learned how to build communication skills.
Goshen High School's art department is having an art show. It will start later today at 5 p.m. Some works from students will be displayed. It's a free event, so anyone who enjoys viewing art made from students can attend.
GTV students are showing how GHS teachers use their learner profiles. This week, Cameron introduces us to Mrs. Yoder and what it means to be a thinker.
Mrs. Yoder is an engineering teacher here at Goshen High School. I interviewed her to get her opinion on what it means to live your life as a thinker.
It means that you are constantly taking in your environment, making decisions. You can't make a decision without thinking about things. Problem solving, just always making connections in your mind.
You can apply the qualities of being a thinker in your everyday life. You can be a thinker just by making basic decisions or by critically thinking about what you're doing.
Just at my job, I'm constantly thinking, thinking about how can I make this lesson more interesting for students, or how can I just spark some excitement in this student. I'm also a mom, and when that, that involves constantly thinking, making sure I'm doing things the best that I can. Really, I don't think it's possible at all to be breathing and not thinking.
Being a student can be pretty hard sometimes. Having a social life while also maintaining your grades is a struggle for a lot of students. That's why being a thinker can help you go above and beyond.
You've got to have that drive to want to solve some problems, or don't just take things at status quo. You can be a better thinker just by questioning things, questioning things appropriately, but just don't take things at face value. Always go deeper, see what else you can learn.
Critical thinking can be applied to almost every aspect of your life. So try and apply some thinking skills to important things in your life. You might find better results if you take your time and think about it.
Now, it's time for the sports segment.
Drew and Logan, take it away.
Hello, fellow sports lovers. I'm Drew.
And I'm Logan.
Let's get into these sports announcements. Results from the Goshen Boys Golf versus LaVille on Monday. The Redhawks defeated LaVille at Black Squirrel 181-275. Junior Jacob Moyer led the Redhawks with a 43.
The Lady Redhawks had a handful of athletes compete at the John Reed Relays Saturday in East Noble. The Redhawks still had a solid fourth place finish. The Spring Medley Relay took first place. Natalie Escuela got a PR in the true mile.
Last week, boys track dropped their meet to Concord in Warsaw. There were some first and second place finishes for the Redhawks. Finishing first was Drew Hogan and Cole Johnson. Picking up second place finishes were Wyatt Hernley, Mario Santos, Caden Evans, Jordan Williams, Cole Johnson, Alex Lopez, Drew Hogan, and Luis Loera.
In girls tennis, the shorthanded Lady Redhawks fell to visiting Plymouth 1-4 on Tuesday. The number one doubles pair of Jorna Drenth and Catelyn Detweiler improved to 11-1 with a straight set win.
Boys baseball picked up a win on Tuesday night against the Bethany Christian Bruins by a score of 12-2. Miss Daniels picked up a win on the mound for the Redhawks, pitching four innings, giving up one run. The offense got started early when Thomas Costello got a base hit and stole five bases, scoring on a single by Colin Turner and up driving in three runs.
Girls softball beat Northwood 5-2 on Monday. Olivia Korschmeter and Emma Detweiler each had three hits. Tyra Markham got the win on the mound. The Redhawks are now 11-6 overall.
Unified track is a great opportunity for all students to participate in a spring sport. GTV student Graham Templeton is a member of the Unified Track team. He introduces us to a fellow team member and their coach so we can learn more.
Unified Track and Field is a fun way for GHS students to participate in spring sports. Unified Track has many of the same events as the other GHS track teams. It's a fun time because we get to lots of exercise and compete in fun events. We talked with student athlete Mars Simpson and Coach Lee Oliveira about being in Unified Track.
It's seeing the face of the athletes, how much they work and how much fun they have, and how they get together and they enjoy just spending time together and learning together. Well, one of the things that you can do is cheer our kids when you see them around the school coming to our meets, especially on the home one.
I like doing the batons because it's really fun and I like it, and you don't have to run as much. Just to like have fun and gain the experience and to just enjoy themselves and just like have fun.
We have learned a lot from our coaches, and in the end we give awards and snacks. You can come cheer us on Friday, May 7th here at home, or next Thursday, May 13th in Warsaw at our meets. For GTV Sports, I'm Graham Tolton.
Good luck to the Unified Track team as they host their meet tonight. That's it for sports. Now back to Cameron and Harjit for the rest of the show.
Do you want to do weather again?
after what happened last time.
Okay, you know what, fair enough.
We're gonna let Graham do it this time.
Welcome back to weather. May the 7th be with you. Friday, the high will be 57 degrees and the low will be 32 degrees at freezing point. Saturday, the high will be 56 degrees and low 39 degrees. Sunday, the high will be 52 degrees and low 38 degrees. For those of you hoping for warm weather next week, don't get too excited because the high will be right around 60 degrees.
You know, I'm cloud nine after that weather report, Graham. Thanks. Now, 2 weeks ago, in a galaxy far, far away, also known as Ms. Shetler's classroom, our academic Super Bowl teams competed against other schools to qualify for state. Unfortunately, none of our teams qualified, but they still managed to do well. Congratulations to all competed. You'll get them next year.
You often get to learn about predators and prey in your biology classes. Usually, you're just reading about the predators. Calvin Russell shows you how Mrs. Gottwalls made the learning real in her classroom.
And so you say, there's been an owl here. So you look on the ground to see if there's pellets. If they've been roosting there, you'd probably cough up some pellets. And so what you do is you step back about 4 or 5 feet, okay? Close your mouth and look up, and you can possibly find one of these guys to sit right next to the trunk of a tree.
Monday the 26th, Mrs. Gottwald's first, third, and fifth period bio classes had an opportunity to meet with some unusual guests. The bird rehabilitation group, Soarin' Hawks, located in Fort Wayne, brought different kinds of predator birds to present to the class and show their purpose and importance in the outdoors and the food chain. They brought flying predators to show the students, like Puck, the eastern screech owl who was hit by a car.
The back of the skull there. So it's tubular in shape, so light comes in and it's concentrated back there on that retina. And behind that retina is a membrane that's reflective. You know, you see
Sherman, the short-eared owl who was struck in the wing by an airplane.
Their wings up in the beak, and that's so that it lowers their center of gravity so that they can fly slower and be more stabilized so that they can find their food. So
Cheyenne, the Harris hawk who was electrocuted on a telephone pole.
Waiting, okay? So one chases the jackrabbit or ground squirrel or whatever, and the other three are waiting, and then when the prey comes by, they descend upon it, and then they all share the food quite often.
And Ruby, a red-tailed hawk who has had a crop injury and has poor vision. With every bird except the Harris hawk being native, students had the chance to be up and personal with the birds, and you can see or hear them every day here in Indiana. The students got to learn why they're important in the food chain in our local area.
So as he's flying along, those little fly loop plumes are sitting there, waving back and forth, and they're detecting motion, speed, that kind of thing. So all that instrumentation is going down there into the bird to let him know what's going on. And again, like he said,
this is Calvin Russell signing off with GTV.
Last episode, we promised to follow up on the Earth Day Millrace cleanup that happened 2 weeks ago on Earth Day. We have some new information along with some pictures to show you. This event was organized by Katie Batson, who cleaned up the Millrace along with her little sister Ella Batson, a few other high school students, a couple of elementary school students, and two teachers. They all worked together to pick up around a grocery bag's worth of trash each over the course of 1 hour. Thank you to Katie and all those who volunteered for helping to keep our community clean and our planet clean.
Is your summer looking kind of bland? Well, the 4-H Fair is back with all the food and rides you could ever dream of. The fair will be running from July 23rd to the 31st, and we'll be hosting events like the Hot Air Balloon Race, Kids Day, Classic Car Cruising, a Corvette Show, and much more. Make sure to check it out this summer.
Next up, Abby talks about the audition process for choir and how it's getting updated.
The Goshen High School chorus teachers decided to update the audition process for students. That's because the teachers felt the old way scared students. The teachers think the new process will make auditions fair for all students who want to be involved in music. Mr. Snyder has been a teacher in the music department at Goshen High School for 10 years. He directs the Men's Crimson Choir, the Advanced Crimson Choir, and the Mixed Crimson Choir. He told us about the new audition process.
New choir audition process. It's been simplified from previous years. We found that in previous years, while students who'd been through choir a year could be quite successful at it, it often scared some of them away because it was so large and so lengthy. So we're trying to make it easier for both the students in choir, but especially the students that aren't currently in choir, but would like to try to sign up for next year.
Teachers want to get more students involved in the GHS choir program. They say the new process is low-pressuring and welcoming to students. Anyone is welcome to try out. Mr. Snyder says students are very excited about the brand new way to audition.
We just found that it was a little cumbersome, a little difficult, and maybe even, to use the word, scary. So now it's just down to three pieces. All people have to do that are interested in one of the auditioned choirs. There are also unauditioned choirs. But if someone's interested in an auditioned choir, they need to sing 8 measures of music for us. They could do more if they wish. They need to echo patterns back. We'll play something on the piano, and they should echo it back, sing it back to us. There'll be a few of those. And then need to interpret 8 measures of music. So they can do the rhythm, they could do the pitch, they could just have their voice go up and down to follow the contour. Make those things acceptable. Those three pieces, and that's the whole audition.
Goshen High School choir programs are here to bring the community together with their spirit and voices. For GTV, I'm Abby Rao.
A legendary battle occurred on April 24th to fight for the right to be named Josh. What started as an internet meme involving a group chat and a cryptic message eventually turned into hundreds of pounds of food being donated and more than $8,000 being raised for charity. After a rock, paper, scissors match between Josh Swain and Josh Swain, a pool noodle fight to the death involving everyone named Josh decided the one true Josh. Congratulations to 4-year-old Josh Vincent Jr., who won the fight and is now crowned King of the Josh.
Logan teamed up with Duncan to take his questions from Snapchat to the halls of GHX. Take it away, Logan.
What does that mean? This is Mark, the dumbest person in the world.
The dumbest.
Alright, how about you?
Smartest.
Why'd you say you'd rather be the dumbest person in the world?
Nah, because if you're the dumbest, then you know all the wrong answers, right? So.
That's facts.
I'm trying to write bank in the future.
Yes.
Alright, daily questions. What's the dumbest thing you've done? I reported a 5 freshman year in the locker room. Oh, I wonder whose fight it was.
I wonder whose fight it was too.
You can choose who the president would be. Who'd you pick?
You.
Why?
Because you're you.
Great answer.
Nicholas. Me.
Why?
I agree with that.
Adrian Munoz.
Your papi Munoz?
Why?
It's skinny.
Good answer. On a daily question, if you have 10 minutes to spend $1 million, what would you buy?
I'll probably buy a BMW to get one.
Okay.
Quick
question. Can it be Goku?
Yeah,
I
can.
Okay. Logan, what do you do? Question. Would you rather be a child right now with all the knowledge you have now? Or be 40 in a million?
I think a child.
Why?
Because then I would like be really smart and whatnot.
Good answer. Why? Good answer. Daily question. Now, how are you gonna die, or when are you gonna die?
I think I'm gonna die by drowning in a pool filled with chocolate milkshake.
Good
I think I'm gonna die, let's say 2050, on my birthday.
Good answer. Daily question. What's the dumbest thing you've ever done? Thank you.
Alright, we're here with
Israel.
Question of the day, what's your dream car?
I gotta give it to the McLaren P1.
Alright, and not trying to be cocky or anything, but you'll probably lose to my BMW.
We're gonna have to see you on the track.
Alright, man.
Thank you all for joining us on the final episode of GTV. Okay, well, it's not actually the last episode, but we do actually only have one more after this.
Sit tight, everyone. It's going to be a good one. See you around, GHS.